Hi, my name is Darren Mueller, Extension Plant Pathologist here at Iowa State University. Today we're standing in a fungicide plot here in central Iowa where we're looking at quite a bit of frog eye leaf spot really throughout the plots. And so one of the things that we've noticed over the last couple of years is that we've had development of resistant strains of several different pathogens to one of the classes of fungicides. And so I'll take a step back. There's three main classes of fungicides that are going to be used in soybeans. And one of those is going to be the Strobilurin, or the QOI fungicides. One of them is the triazoles, or the DMI fungicides, and then one of those is the SDHI fungicides. A lot of the products that we have are going to be premixes of some of those classes of fungicides. Some of them are just premixes of two, and then some of them are actually premixes of all three classes of those fungicides. And so as you're doing your homework, you need to really think, know what of which one of those classes of fungicides are going to be sprayed on your soybeans. That matters because some of the strains of the pathogens that we have out there are now resistant to that first class of fungicides that we talked about, the QOI or the Strobilurin fungicides. All right, so what does it mean that you have fungicide resistance? And so I like to say, well, you should be familiar with resistant pest sort of from the herbicide world, or there are actually some insects that are resistant as well. It's the same thing when you're looking at fungicides or looking at fungi. Some of the pathogens can have mutations and they can be different. And then as you spray a fungicide, what you're doing is you're actually selecting for that class of, or that group of pathogens that are resistant, and eventually you'll end up with all of them being resistant. In our world, in the QOI resistance world, when you spray a fungicide and that fungus is not sensitive to it, which means it's resistant, that means that you a lot of times it's qualitative. It means it's yes or no. And so the resistance is going to be 100%, which means when you spray a product that is a QOI or a Strobilurin alone, you'll end up having absolutely no response to that fungicide, which means, and I'm actually standing in a plot right now where we sprayed a QOI fungicide, and if you look at the disease levels in this plot and you compared it to the untreated control, you would actually not see any differences. All right, so which diseases are going to be affected by this fungicide resistance developing? And then, and there's really two main ones here in Iowa. The first one is frog eye leaf spot. And this is not a surprise. We've seen frog eye resistance developing in other states down further south, and then over in Illinois as well. And so that's not a surprise. And the other one is Septoria brown spot. And unfortunately, as you start looking at the profile of diseases that should be targeted with a fungicide application, it's really frog eye leaf spot and brown spot. Those are the two main foliar diseases that we would expect to be affected by a fungicide application here in Iowa. And so what we have here in this plot would be those two diseases. And so the first one is brown spot, that's in the lower canopy, and you can see a lot of the brown spots on the leaves. And the other one would be frog eye leaf spot, that's here, that you can find it in the upper canopy. And again, both of these diseases, the pathogens are going to be resistant to that one class of fungicides. All right, so if you have fungicide resistance, and I think that in Iowa it's safe to say that you should expect to have that. If you have these diseases, you should expect that some of these would be resistant to the QOI fungicides. What do you do about it? So one of the things that you can be doing, as I say, is start with a resistant variety. And so that's going to be that information should be available from your seed dealer. So as you're going out and you're selecting your varieties for the next year, make sure you really focus on a good disease package that's going to be resistant to at least the frog eye leaf spot pathogen. From there, if you choose a variety that ends up being susceptible, or if you're planting seed beans, or if you have, for some reason, you should be spraying a fungicide or need to spray a fungicide, then what you do is you really try to focus on what's left in that fungicide once you remove that QOI fungicide out of the mix. If the QOI fungicide is ineffective, then whatever premix you have, whatever's left is going to be the effective part of that fungicide. And so one valuable resource that you can go to is Crop Protection Network. If you just Googled Crop Protection Network, or you typed in cropprotectionnetwork.org, you should be able to find that webpage. On that webpage, there's a resources tab. That resources tab has an efficacy table for the different fungicides. So get on there, you can do your homework, you can figure out which fungicides are going to be most effective against the diseases that you expect to see on your farm.